by the word of his power. After making purification for sins, sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high, having become as much superior to angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. To which of the angels did he ever say, "You are my son, today I have begotten you"? Yet be to you a father, I shall be to him a son. He brings the firstborn into the world. He says, "Let all God's angels worship him." Of the angels, he says, he makes his angels win, and his ministers a flame of fire. But of the Son, he says, "Your throne, O God, is forever and ever. The scepter of uprightness is the scepter of your kingdom. You have loved righteousness and hated wickedness. Therefore God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness beyond your companions. You have laid the foundations of the earth. Beginning the heavens are the work of your hand. They will perish, but you remain. They will all wear out like a garment. Like a robe you will roll them up. Like a garment they will be changed, but you are the same and your years will have no end." To which of the angels did he ever say, "Sit at my right hand until I make the enemies a footstool for your feet"? Are they not all ministry spirits set out to serve for the sake of those who are to inherit salvation?